so good.
Just amazing. Maxine Richards. There, since he's been gone, it's been very hard for the family. But I would love to thank the population of Trinidad and Tobago for all the outpouring of love, all the messages, all the phone calls. As I said numerous times, I knew my daddy was loved, but I didn't know he was loved like he is by everyone else.
San Fernandians, and I consider the heart of the city, just a very small group of people who can interact with you in this very special period and share their thoughts, those of you, those who knew your father and who knew your father. So you just listen, enjoy the moment at this very difficult period. And at this point, I would like to call Dr. Rupert Indar, the 91-year-old Dr. Rupert Indar, who have very interesting stories to tell. I'm not going to share with you, right? So Dr. Indar. And the reason why he was selected, not only because of his long history with your father and your mother, but he's a recipient of the Keys of the City of. He's the owner of Southern Medical Center. The owner. Okay. I think that right. Right.
Good afternoon, Your Worship. Maxine, deep condolences to the entire family. Max and myself, we were classy together, although I was ahead of him because of age. But I always remembered a very tall, physical person. And we knew each other a little bit then. And subsequently, I went abroad. I then met him when you were the POVOT. And we touched base then. We discussed, there was a project I had in the middle 60s. I discussed it with him. And at that time, he had great knowledge about industry. As he was working on the chipboard, which would use Baggett's. And we met then, we subsequently met in Düsseldorf. And as a result of his advice, I started a plant called Carrier Containers, which manufactured paper cups. Then we met subsequently, and of course, when Max became the president, himself and your mommy were two most gracious people to myself and Polly. I will say there was never an occasion, including his birthday, that we were not invited to his home. At that time, the big house was still functioning, and we were always sat close to him. We were close to him at Mark's wedding, and it went on. I'm very sorry that we couldn't do more for him. I chatted with Mummy from time to time, but I can't only speak about Max. I have to speak about Mummy. And I knew who she was because we all grew up in San Fernando. Their homestead was in Sequeira Street. And I knew of her in Dublin. And then she joined the San Fernando General Hospital when I was a consultant in the early 60s. And as I've told this story a little early on, but I shall repeat it for your benefit. One weekend I was alone as a consultant. I had no junior help. And I asked the superintendent of the hospital to give me some help, and indeed he sent up Jean. And Jean came in the usual matter-of-fact way, and he said, "I'm here, and let me tell you, I'm here only for the weekend." But lo and behold, she stayed on my team for 2 years. And during that time, Mummy became a great surgeon. I was very surprised that she didn't pursue surgery. Nonetheless, she pursued anesthesia as Jean Cox, two Jeans were together, and it was great. So I can again extend my family, Pauline, myself, our deepest condolences. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Guru, a very distinguished person to share thoughts and experiences with our beloved Max. Let's give Mrs. Manning a round of applause.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. When the mayor invited me, was it this morning?
Yesterday.
I thought I had to come. I had to come to even just to say thank you. And thank you to Maxine, her dad, and her mom. We were neighbors for over 10 years. We lived next to each other. And we became close enough so that Patrick was going across there every Thursday morning, I think it was, every Thursday morning with his cabinet box. This is part of the system, the British system, that continues here, where the Prime Minister and the President, they would meet before cabinet to discuss important matters. They took it seriously. Patrick was deliberate, he was intentional, and he did what he had to do. And the president welcomed him and sat and chatted, and they discussed the state of what was happening in the country. He was easy to work with. Patrick was happy working with him. And I'd like to say thanks to him for being a people person, for being someone who loved the culture of this country, for someone who believed in what was happening, believed in the new development of the country, who believed in the reform that was taking place, and supported and assisted. Someone who believed in the culture of this country and added so much to it. So on behalf of my family, your neighbors, your one-time neighbors, I'd like to say thank you very much. And I'm sure on behalf of the people of San Fernando that I can also say thank you very much.
This is my tool for making myself a big lady, but that's precisely the position. It's very soft. And having said that, I will ask the I don't know if anybody would like to say or share their thoughts before I call on the CEO and myself to wrap up. It's open. Anybody want to share their thoughts with this very, very, what shall I say, good gentleman? I'm glad that he lived. Here I'll ask the Deputy CEO, Mrs. Bettiani, on behalf of the corporation, to share. Being prepared.
Well, it's not only prepared, it's just that I don't want to forget the important things that I need to say. So, Maxine, the San Fernando City Corporation conveys its deepest condolences to you, your mom, and your family, and all who mourn the passing during this period of bereavement. And we wish to say thank you for his loyal and his dedicated service. I want to say that he clearly demonstrated his humanity and his ability to bridge all divides in society. He was commonly and affectionately called Max by the people, of course, who saw him as being down to earth, approachable, especially through his love of life, of the arts, national culture, and carnival in particular. It is even noteworthy that every faith in our country has expressed sadness at his passing and reflected on his positive role as a president. Our warmest, deepest condolences.
My experience with Max was quite different. Whenever I met Max, he'd say to me, "So when skipper will win a panorama?" He said, "But I say, but you supported Exodus." He said, "But I lived in St. Augustine for all these years. It's not that I want to support Exodus. You're not winning nothing, win something." So that became our marginal meet. That was our conversation. One of the moments that stand out to me was, sure, Max, you remember this occasion, was the Palm Sunday concert. I knew it conceptualized, but one Palm Sunday, we got a call that he was gathering the top steel bands in the country. I was supposed to keep one of them. At GMPI complex, together with Libyan singers and minor choir and Sunday choir, and we all did classical music on a Palm Sunday, and we ended the concert with an hardware chorus that will stand out. And then he gave us a very nice little token, a gold strip, you know, acknowledging the event and what transpired. That was very special because to get 500 singers and 10 steel bands playing the hardware chorus together is amazing. And it was very well conducted, very well thought of, and we have the part fertility, you know, we want to say thank you for putting that project and bringing that idea forward. So much has been said about him, and as Maxine said several times, that she knew that he was so loved. And we have a way in this country, we that people pass to say. But I think people, I think he knew, because whenever you come across anybody whose name was mentioned, to talk about him, because which president you refer to as Max, you know? And he didn't have a problem with it. I saw Kurt Nagel made a comment on papers this week. He said that some time ago he criticized the president because he was very harsh of what he had to say. He said about 3 weeks or 3 months after he was appointed as an independent senator. So he said, "Well, I have to be honest with him." He said, President Richards called me in. He said, "President Richard, before I accept this instrument, I want to let you know that I criticize you and my opinion will remain the same." You see, we didn't come here for that. You see, Mr. Hansel was saying, we came here to make a contribution, you have a contribution to make. That showed how forthright he was and how honest he was and how he really wanted to put the best minds forward that would carry Trinidad to go forward. On behalf of the people's gifts, I want to tell you about our thoughts with you and your family in this very, very difficult period. on the tap, you will find the sharing markets. We will spend some time this evening. We have some, I know a CEO snubbing our orange juice, and we had a big debate in this discussion today. The debate was to bring some scotch and some Hawaiian, and then the lady said, no, Mayor, this is solemn, this is Sunday evening. So nobody considered what Max would have wanted, because today is you week. You
know?
All of that was considered. But I give in. Today and I said, okay, we'll have the lime juice and we have some fantastic pastry that we shared just now on its way. So mingle, talk, look at these distinguished gentlemen who shaped San Fernando over the years. Ladies and gentlemen, sorry, the gender minority here. So really, I must thank everybody for coming. It's only what I call Marcus. If I call you Tuesday night. Because I call you, she said, listen, we have a viewing on Saturday, I'm viewing body on Saturday. I said, I can't see, but she called back and said, okay, Junior, I will come on Sunday at 2 o'clock. So I said, okay, I have quite a bit of time to call up a few people, but I called people who I know, I shared their experience this evening, and they all graciously accepted to come at short notice to be here. That's how they feel about the Marks and Confucius. Thank you all, and condolences to your family, and thanks for considering the government. Because as San Fernando, we're not part of what is happening, there's a state matter. This is San Fernando saying to your father and the family, we really appreciate your appreciation. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Lead by example.
Everybody agree for juice. But us, you know something? I didn't ask Maxine to say something.
Just really want to thank you all for everything. It would mean a lot to him. And just thank you for all the support that you've given my family and myself since his passing on Monday. And one thing I should note, you all are getting the best part of him. You know, his ashes are being scattered in
the Gulf of Paria.
At San Fernando.
So he's here with us.
Yes, he's going to be with you for life. For wherever. Till eternity. Okay, thanks again.
People want to know why Jamaica runs from the Federation. Well, they want to know why Jamaica ran away from the Federation. Jamaica have a right to speak she mine, that is my opinion. And if you believe in democracy, you'll agree with me. But if they know they didn't want Federation, and they know they don't want to unite as one, independence was at the door. Why didn't they speak before? This is no time to say you are federated no more. Big fight. When Sir Bradley Adams took up his post, that even made things worse. They call it, we ain't want no major premier. Trinidad can't be capital for here. So the grumbling went on and on to a big referendum. But if they know they didn't want
Federation,
and they know they don't want to unite as one and only one, I said, don't tell the doctor you're not in favor. Don't behave like a blasting traitor. How the devil you mean you're federated no more?
Oh.
big shame. After so much efforts and energy, goodbye everybody. Right now it's only a memory. We fail miserably. Some may say we shouldn't have parted, but the Jamaica way started. If they know they didn't want federation, and they know they don't want to unite as one, just tell the doctor you're not in favor. Don't behave like a blasted traitor. This is no time to say you are federating no more. Survival of the fittest. Everybody fighting for independence, singularly Trinidad, for instance. We gon' get it too, so don't bother. But I find we should all be together, not separated as we are, because of Jamaica. If they know they didn't want federation.